Linkletter, I need to talk to you.
Are we in my office?
No.
And these are not my office hours.
Are you using my level of schedules against me?
Oh, yes.
Well done. Dr. Linkletter, I need to talk to you.
Great.
Do you think you could get me access to the telescope room? I want to search for exoplanets that could support life.
Are you feeling homesick?
Are you implying that I'm from another planet?
Yes.
Compliment accepted. Now, about the telescope room. I was watching Star Trek and it got me thinking.
Sheldon, searching for life on other planets isn't serious science. Leave that to the tinfoil hat brigade.
But statistically, given the number of stars and planets, it's likely we could find one capable of supporting life, and if we did, it would be the greatest scientific discovery of all time.
Yes, and if I had fruit on my head, I'd be Carmen Miranda.
I'm not familiar with that reference.
She sang and danced with fruit on her head.
Why would she have fruit on her head?
I don't know, in case she got hungry. It's not going to happen, Sheldon.
How can you just dismiss a line of inquiry out of hand?
Sheldon, sometimes I say no just for kicks. This time it's for your own good. Scientists who pursue little green men get laughed at.
Well, I care about science, not my reputation. And if you're not willing to help me, I know someone who is.
We'll be mocked by physicists, engineers, even mathematicians. And they don't just say you're an idiot, they prove it.
And if I had fruit on my head, I'd be Carmen Miranda.
What?
I didn't understand it either. President Hagemeyer, we have a problem.
What now, Sheldon? The yoo-hoos in the vending machine aren't cold enough?
Actually, they aren't, but we'll table that for later. I need telescope time to search for exoplanets, and Dr. Linkletter and Dr. Sturgis have denied my request.
Why?
They said that kind of research would expose both me and the university to criticism.
Well, that's outrageous.
So you'll give me access?
Gosh, you know, I want to, but I'm just the president. You said the telescope has to be approved by a science advisor.
Is that true?
Well, does it sound true?
I suppose it does.
Then I suppose it is.
Why did I even come to you?
Remember that next time.
I still needed to find an advisor to approve my research. Some intrepid soul who was unafraid of tarnishing their reputation by taking a chance on a brilliant mind and a bold, untested idea.
No.
No.
Exoplanets. No.
Dr. Evans, I have...
No.
Eight no's, three belly laughs, and one professor who pretended not to speak English later, I found my man.
Excuse me, Dr. Prakash, I'm Sheldon Cooper.
Of course. I've heard a lot about you.
And I've heard nothing about you. Dr. Prakash, I'm on the hunt for a mentor who's not afraid to challenge entrenched scientific paradigms.
Well, mainstream science has always been threatened by new ideas.
True. Like Galileo being imprisoned for his heliocentric model of the universe.
Did you know Semmelweis was put in an asylum for suggesting that doctors wash their hands?
I did. Did you know that Michael Servetus discovered pulmonary circulation and was burned at the stake?
Or Henry Oldenburg was arrested
as a spy for corresponding with scientists from other countries?
This isn't a competition.
Oh, I thought we were bonding.
Fair enough. We're bonding.
How would you feel about joining me in the groundbreaking search for exoplanets that can support life?
I'd love it. How would you feel about joining me in finding subatomic particles that move backwards in time?
You mean tachyons?
Yes.
That's nonsense. Let's get started on my thing. You should know I'm replacing you with a more courageous mentor.
I'm sorry to hear that, Sheldon.
One who's not afraid of new ideas.
Great.
Don't think of it as me walking away. Think of it as you being left behind.
I'm okay with that.
Thank you for helping me on my journey, but you're like a rocket booster that must be discarded for me to reach escape velocity.
I understand.
I'm walking away now.
Goodbye.
I'm walking backwards, so it seems like you're fading into obscurity.
Neat.
Take care. Farewell. Ciao. Bon voyage.
Arrivederci. What a charming young man.
Kook.